Hello friends, in my this video, I am going to discuss another very important matrix-related program in MATLAB and Java. And the question is, print what triangular matrix pattern from given array. Okay, so what is that? Suppose user gives input this array 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then the output matrix should be printed like this. See, this is one lower triangular matrix where all the elements above the body diagonal are zeros, and see the pattern. First one is printed in the first element of the array, in the second row 1, 2 is printed, in the third row 1, 2, 3 is printed, in the fourth row 1, 2, 3, 4, and in the fifth row 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is printed. Okay, like if user gives input 1, 2, 3, then first row 1, 0, 0, second row 1, 2, 0, third row 1, 2, 3. In this way, it should be printed. So, how to write such program which will do this operation? Just try to think in a logical way. So, first step is obviously this is lower triangular matrix. So, as I have already discussed the trick in my previous video, that low means low. That means, see, this is lower triangular, right? So, low, that means there is similar kind of pronunciation as row. So, row should be lower than column for lower triangular matrix, and it will make 0. Okay? So, that is, if I less than j, then for lower triangular matrix, that position will have 0 value. Okay? So, obviously, that concept we have to use. And then, if I not less than j, then print accordingly. That is the simple code, right? So, basically, you can write the code like this. First, CLC clear and close all, you can write like this. Warning off also you can include. Then, x equal to input enter the array. Then, l equal to length of x. In l variable, we are storing the length. Because in MATLAB, dynamically length will be, dynamically array can be given as input. So that after giving input, we are calculating the length. Therefore, I equal to 1 colon L, we are defining one variable k equal to 1. Whenever this code will go to a new row, and see what will happen for columns, for j equal to 1 colon L, obviously as it is going to be square matrix, so for I is equal to 1 colon L, for j equal to 1 colon L, okay? If I less than j is satisfied, y of ij equal to 0, because there is lower triangular matrix. Else, y of ij equal to x of k. X of k is what? X is our input array. X of k. So first, x of 1 has to be extracted, so I have defined that k equal to 1. So x of 1 will be extracted, then k equal to k plus 1. Then for the j loop itself, from the x, it will take accordingly the elements, and whenever it go to next row, again k will be initialized as 1. So it will start from, again, the first element of the input array. Okay, in this if else, in this internal for, in this external for, and at the end of this particular execution, in y array, y 2D array or matrix, our desired output will be stored. Let us check. Control A, evaluate selection, enter the array. Suppose let me give 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Enter. Now you write small y and enter. See this matrix. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Above that 1, 2, 3, 4, 0. Above that 1, 2, 3, 0, 0. Above that 1, 2, 0, 0, 0. Above that 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. So our desired matrix it is printed. Let us check for one more case. Suppose enter the array 4, 5, 6. Okay. See you write y and enter. See. Again, same working. It is performing. Okay. So, our code is perfectly working for this particular program. Now, let us try to implement same program in Java also. So, let me open Notepad. See, here I have already written that code as the explanation is going to be same like in MATLAB. Just syntax will differ and will be different. So, see, from the beginning, we'll go step by step. So, see, first, in Java, to take the input from the user, we have to import either the buffer reader class or the scanner class. So, I am using scanner class because we are discussing integer related array. So, no issue in taking scanner class. But if you are taking buffer, if you are working with string related programs, then better to use buffer reader. Okay. So, import java.util.scanner. We have imported the scanner class from the util package in Java. Then class, LOVU, I have defined a class. Then public static void main string args. Then we have created this scanner object in this scanner class. Scanner object equal to new scanner system.in. System.out.println enter the array length. Then int l equal to object.next. See, here in Java, to create the array before we should define this space so that we are taking the array length. But in MATLAB, you can dynamically arrange so that after taking input, we are calculating length of the array, right? But if in Java, if you want, then you have to go through linked list concept, which is a bit difficult. You should have a clear idea in data structure. So what I have done here is an array. No issue in that. Then we have taken input from the user for int I equal to 0, I less than li plus plus ak of I at the 0 next bit, because we have defined our empty array int ak equal to new int of length l. Okay? Then, as our output will be a square matrix of l cross l, so we have defined first our empty matrix of l cross l. Then, same algorithm we have used here for int I equal to 0, I less than li plus plus. Int p equal to 0, this is equivalent to k equal to 1 in MATLAB program, because in MATLAB array index starts from 1, but in Java it starts from 0. So I have defined here int p equal to 0. And don't forget to define the data type of the variable, because in Java it is required, but in MATLAB it is not required. Therefore, int j equal to 0, j less than l, j plus plus, this is equivalent to for j equal to 1 colon l. If I less than j, a of I j equal to 0. Like here I have defined if I less than j, y of I j equal to 0. Else, a of I j equal to a k of p. Like here y of I j equal to x of k. Here k equal to k plus 1. Similarly here p equal to p plus 1. That's all. And at last we have to print, right? So we have printed here. Let's check whether our code is working or not. So go to current prompt. Then cd java java c l o p u dot java. Then Java LOVU, because our class name is LOVU, right? So enter the array length, suppose it may be 5 and elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, see, this kind of not triangular pattern is created when the first array 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, then 1, 2, 0, 0, 0, then 1, 2, 3, 0, 0, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One more case, let us check. So enter the array, suppose it is 3, so elements are 4, 7, 8, see, 4, 0, 0, 4, 7, 0, 4, 7, 8, okay. So our Java code also perfectly working. This is all for my this video. Thank you for watching.